Welcome to the next video in our Build Smart Revit Panel Families Guide, Build Smart Revit Panels 201, Floor Plans and Panel Parameters. In this video, we will cover how to put together a simple building using the Build Smart Revit Panel Families that we introduced in the previous video, Build Smart Panels 101. We will also show you the parameters that you can adjust on the panels to fit your project's specific requirements. Today, we are going to design a simple building with a square plan. Now, we are starting from scratch because this is just a simple example plan, but when you are sketching or working on your schematic designs, there are some items that you should remember if you plan on using the Build Smart panel system. First, similar to good building and design practice, you should plan on your exterior dimensions being in 2-foot increments. All our panels are sized in 2-foot increments to allow for efficient use of sheet goods. We do offer a 1-foot wide panel as standard, and you can use it if needed. However, we recommend that you stay away from odd dimensions to increase material efficiency. Second, the sizes and styles of windows and doors are limited, so we recommend keeping that in mind as you're planning your room layouts or elevation designs. Third, the panel heights are limited. Please check our website for the latest information regarding panel heights. As of summer 2015, we are only offering 8-foot and 9-foot high panels as standard, with 10-foot high panels only available as a custom order currently, but we hope to offer them as a standard panel soon. Our Revit families do include all 3 heights for future proofing. However, if you decided to use the 10-foot high panels, please remember that as of summer 2015, they are still a custom order item. Fourth, and finally, there's a specific offset of 1 7/8 inch required between the above-grade panels and the below-grade Build Smart precast wall system. We will show you later where this offset is and how it comes into play with your designs. Now let's start building our house. We recommend that you use the Build Smart template that we have provided on our website when you're starting a new project. It comes with the Build Smart panel components preloaded along with the pre-made levels in the Build Smart panel schedule. Please feel free to customize this template to fit your firm's specific requirements and standards. However, as we mentioned in the introductory video, there are certain elements that we please ask you not to customize or change to ensure efficient and error-free design and ordering of the Build Smart panel system. I will mention these as we go along, or you can review the introductory video. When you start building a Revit model, we recommend starting with placing the corners first, and then placing the door and window panels in the locations that you want them, and then infilling of the straight panels as required. The panels are located in the components library and are easily searchable by type. Once you become more familiar with the panel naming scheme, we will start with our corner panel and select the one that is 8-foot high, which is a 2OC8, which tells you that the panel is 2-foot wide, an outside corner, and 8-foot high. 9-foot high and 10-foot high panels are available as well, but as we mentioned previously, as of summer 2015, the 10-foot high panels are a special order item. All our panels have control arrows, so you can easily flip their direction as needed. We are going to make a 20-foot by 20-foot house in this video, as measured to the exterior face of the panels. We recommend that you follow good design practice and keep your dimensions to multiples of 2 feet to make design and construction more efficient. Like we said before, we do offer a 1-foot wide panel that you can use if needed. Now that we have our corners placed, we will place the front door. The door panels come in 4-foot, 6-foot, and 8-foot widths, with fully opaque, type D1, fully glazed, type D2, and half glass, type D3 doors, in either left-hand or right-hand swings. Our doors and windows follow the European conventions for handedness, where a left-handed door or window has a hinge on the left side of the door or window when viewed from the exterior, and vice versa for a right-handed door or window. Next, we will place our window panels on either side of the door. You have the choice of a single window or a twin window panel. Both window types come in 3 different heights. 3-foot type W1, 5-foot type W2, and 6-foot 6 type W3, which is a 4-foot high operable window above a 2-foot 6 high fixed window. make sure all the edges of your panels are aligned and that there are not small gaps or overlaps that sometimes can occur. Now we will place a straight panel on the next wall. The straight panels come in 2-foot increments from 2 foot to 8 foot, along with a 1 foot wide panel. This gives you the general idea of placing panels, so we will complete the exterior walls and show you what it looks like in a 3D view. Now we can see how the panels look in 3D. You can see the different type of windows we placed, and the two door panels that we placed. See the twin windows, type W3, with the operable windows above and the fixed windows below. See our front doors of type D1, are fully opaque. We're going to change that to type D2, which is a fully glazed door. See, we have a type single window, type W2, and a twin window, type W1. See, the materials are color-coded. The exterior zip system sheathing is green. The EPS foam is gray. The air barrier layer is blue, and the stud layer is orange. Let's go back to the floor plan, and we'll go through the panel parameters that you need to know. These parameters are all type parameters, so they will affect all the same panel types throughout your model. We do offer panel families with instance parameters, and we will cover those in a later video. All the parameters listed in the construction section should not be changed. These are linked to the panel type, and changing them will cause errors in your model. We suggest you collapse this section. The only parameters you need to change, or should change, are located in the dimensions section and are called framing type and insulation depth. These parameters, like their name suggests, control the type of framing used for the panel and the thickness of the rigid insulation on the panel. They are both integer parameters, and the integers correspond to the different types of framing or insulation depths. For the framing type parameter, the default value is 0, which corresponds to 2x4 framing. 2x6 framing is a value of 1, 2x8 framing is a value of 2, 2x10 framing is a value of 3, and 2x12 framing is a value of 4. The insulation depth parameter works in a similar way, however the default for it is a value of 2, which corresponds to 5.5 inches of insulation. The available insulation depths range from 3.5 inches to 12.5 inches. Those are the only parameters in the type properties window that you need to change. Everything else is off limits except for some of the parameters listed in the identity data section. Most of these are not associated with any element in the family except for model and type comments, but those are not editable fields and please do not edit them in the family. You're welcome to use the rest of the parameters in the identity data section if your firm requires them. Let's go back to the floor plan, and we'll show you how to add interior and exterior finishes to your building. Let's start on the exterior, with adding clapboard siding over rainscreen battens. We have a pre-built wall type with two layers. One is the 3/4 inch rainscreen space, and the other is the clapboard siding. Feel free to make your own wall types, but you only need to include the finished layers like you see here. Basically, any material exterior of the wall sheathing that you would normally include on your exterior wall types is what you should use for your new wall type. For example, if you have an existing wall type created with the finish that you want to use, you can simply duplicate the type and remove the sheathing and everything interior of the sheathing to get your new wall type. Once you have your wall type selected, just place the wall along the outside face of the panels. You want to make sure that your top constraint is something reasonable. For example, we're going to select the top of the first floor top plate for our purposes. Location line should be set for core face interior, making sure your interior face is against the panel sheathing. Interior works the same way. We have a pre-made half-inch chipboard wall type, and we will just place it on the inside face of the studs, similar to what we did on the exterior. Now for the interior finish, you want to make sure that your top constraint is at the top of the first floor top plate level, or whatever level you are on. Select core face interior and click to start your wall. Hit space to flip the wall so it faces the proper direction if needed. Now you can see that while we have our wall finishes in, the doors and windows are covered up by our finished walls. This is easy to fix, as our panel families come with cutting elements preloaded, so all you have to do is select one of the walls that you want to cut, click Cut Geometry, select the wall you want to cut again, and then click the panel you want to cut a hole for. Now repeat this around your building on the interior and exterior. You can do this in whatever view you want, but we are in the 3D view for this demonstration. Once you have cut the walls with the panels, the openings will automatically update when you change your panel type like so. That concludes this lesson on placing the panels on a floor plan, adding finishes, and adjusting the panel parameters. Our next video, BuildSmart 301, will cover modeling the basement using the BuildSmart Precast Basement System, along with modeling two or more floors using the BuildSmart Panel System. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to our channel and visit BuildSmartNA.com for more information.